You may have come across it before. It's a quote from Albert Einstein. We cannot solve our problems with the same thinking that we used when we created them. We cannot solve our problems with the same thinking that we used when we created them. So if this is true, and I believe it to be true, it means a lot of the ways that we have been thinking need to be changed in order for us to address the complexities and to come up with new solutions for the future. We all know that we're in this time of exponential change, hyper-competition and globalization. In fact, futurists say that we're only really at the tip of the iceberg. And actually, the next 30 years, things are going to change so dramatically from what we know right now that most of the knowledge that we have now will be out of date. And what is really going to be important for us is to think about how we use our skills, in a sense, our innovation personality. And that's really what I want to talk to you about today. So, here we are. Here we are, sitting down in this room, and we've all been born for such a time as this. In all of history, you are now here. You are now here, 2016, with the type of personality that you have, the skills that you have, the knowledge that you have, the knowledge that you're going to gain in the future. So in a sense, we're being called, I believe, to higher levels of creativity, higher levels of courage, to be able to step into fields of innovation leadership. So when I think about innovation personality or innovation type, what I mean by that is our soft skills, our soft competences, our abilities to be able to do things, our capabilities, our soft capabilities, our abilities to network, our abilities to build partnerships, our abilities to influence, our abilities to persuade. Things that we're not often taught, really, unless you go on some sort of soft skills training in life. But these are the skills that are going to become more and more critical for us as innovators. And our capacities. Our capacities is about really our how we think, our mindsets, the ways that we can shift and think differently, depending on what we're actually trying to do. This is what we need for now, as well as into the future. And we know that innovating is a journey. It's not like there's just a nice straight line. It's very much a hard, arduous journey for pioneering, because what we're trying to do hasn't often been done. That's why it's innovative. But we need different maps that are going to help us on this journey. And several years ago, quite frustrated with the lack of innovation models that were available, that would really integrate the individual, the team, the organizational, and the cultural elements together into one system, I decided to invent one. I couldn't find one. So I worked along with work psychologists. I have a background in social psychology myself, and I worked with clients, both corporations, and with entrepreneurial startups that I was working with, to think about, from the human perspective, when we're looking at building teams, when we're looking at understanding our own strengths, and how we can leverage the diversity of different people to innovate, what would be a good system? What could be a way of actually visualizing and helping individuals and teams innovate more effectively? So I created this model. It's called the Six Eyes of Innovation. And I will just take you through it briefly right now. I'm very happy to share more information about this with anybody if they're interested afterwards. So we've got these six distinct phases. Identify, from a soft skills perspective, our ability to see patterns, to be able to see where opportunities might be rising in the future, to understand trends, to see discontinuities. Ignite, our ability to create new and novel solutions for those identified opportunities, the spark of a new idea. Investigate, our ability to research, test, prototype, make sure an idea is going to be useful, not just novel, but keep and retain novelty through that process. Invest, our ability to persuade, to build business models that don't exist yet, to be able to create new partnerships and get people on board to back an idea. Implement, the hard work of innovation, the ability to build teams and to make new things happen. The ability to be able to, again, create those partnerships with others so that you can really drive value out of the idea. And improve, the ability to be able to optimize and to see where you can actually extract more value and do more things with what you've already created. And interlocking in the whole model is intent, purpose. What is it I'm trying to do? What is it we're trying to do? What do we really want to create? And you can see that intent is interlocked with two triangles that link into each of these eyes. What I wanted to do when I created this model was to take into account two other elements, culture and process. Culture can kill innovation. Team environments can kill innovation. You can have the greatest ideas, but if they're not in a social system that gives rise to those ideas and allows them to flourish, they can die. You can have the most inventive and creative people, but if they're not in a system that allows them to be able to invent, then those ideas can die. But we need different culture at each stage of the I. So we need a different culture for the ignite phase, a different culture for the implement phase. We also need processes that can support innovation, whether it's individual process or organizational. So in a sense, the model brings together the complexity of the human process or the organizational process of innovating. So what I did was I then created an assessment tool that sits behind the model so that you as an individual can understand your innovation strengths on the six I's. First of all, we have these different mindsets which link in to each of the I's. How curious are you? Curiosity is linked to our ability to identify. How creative are you? Linked to our ability to ignite. How critical are you? In a good sense, a critical thinker. Linked to our ability to investigate. How courageous are you? Linked to our ability to invest. And how conscientious? Linked again to the ability to implement. And lastly, clever. Linked to the ability to optimize. So with the individual assessment, what each eye has six interrelated attributes which make up a person's innovation style. So this particular person, you can see, is very high in a normed group, so it's all statistically validated against a global population, on being good at investing and implementing. So they're good at really building business models and making something happen. Whereas this person here is high on identify and ignite. So they're good at identifying where opportunities might be, but also getting new ideas. But it's good to know where we are, but what about what is important to us now so that we can close the gaps between what we need and what we're good at? From a soft skills perspective. So in the assessment, what I did was I built in importance scores. So you can see for the first person that whilst they're good at invest and implement, it's not as critical to their role as their skill set, but they need to be around people or to develop capabilities on identify and ignite. And for the other person who happens to be an entrepreneur, where everything is important to this individual, they're good at certain areas around identify and ignite, but if they don't partner with people or build capabilities, then their ideas aren't going to go anywhere. So this is all about thinking holistically as a system to try to understand and make innovation more likely to be able to happen. So what we can do once we have the data is to aggregate it to understand a team style. So where is the team going to be strong? Where will its blind spots be? And also to break these down so you can actually see the individual attributes, so you can help to skill people up and understand how that they can strengthen their ability. And lastly, we can look at how to manage innovation across these six I's to make sure we don't get stuck in one because of our preference. If you're a high igniter, you're more likely to be stuck in lots of ideas because that's what you enjoy and what you're strong at. But then what happens is that you don't drive the idea through to implementation and values are created. Or if you're a great implementer, the reverse can be true. So the system comes together, in a sense, to create what is actually quite complex. And why a lot of innovation does fail is down a lot of the time to human endeavors not actually being able to come together to be able to optimize on different strengths. So what we want to try to do is to make sure that we're not just leaving things to lady luck or the hope that something might happen, but to have a stronger understanding of our own skills, our mindsets and capacities. So in conclusion, there are three things I'd like to leave you with. The quote again from Albert Einstein, we cannot solve our problems with the same thinking we used when we created them. So we've got to be thinking differently, and to have this versatility and adaptability is what's going to help us, because the domain knowledge which we have now will be redundant quite fast. Know your strengths, know where you're good and what you contribute, and play to your strengths. Don't try to be what you're not, but partner with those that are good so that you can build strong and successful teams. And thirdly, be that innovation leader. You have been born for such a time as this, standing on the precipice of the unknown, and we all need to be able to have that courage and have that determination and grit, that determination to succeed, to be able to hang in there. Because innovation needs leaders. Innovation needs people that are going to have the courage to be able to do things and to do it differently. So what I'd like to leave you with for this evening, this is the end of the conference today, is when you get home tonight, just get out a piece of paper and think about yourself. Think about where you are right now, what you're doing, and draw three circles. In the first, you could just put down some of your skills, your experiences, your talents, what you think you're good at. In another circle, put in your interests, your passions, your desires, things that give you that energy, that motivate you, that are your internal engine. And third, what are the needs of organizations, of society, of the world around you that you're particularly interested in? It could be science. It could be education. It could be religion or spirituality. It could be politics, business, the arts. It could be medicine, technology, media. All of these different domains are being confronted with discontinuities, and a lot of them are merging. They're so ripe for innovation. So think about where the intersection is between these three areas. This is your sweet spot, and this is your place to start. Thank you very much.